जय हिंद एवरीवन, दिस इज रितिका ध्यानी फ्रॉम सीएससी डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम एकेजीईसी कॉलेज. सो द टुडेज वीडियो लेक्चर इज ऑन द टॉपिक थ्योरी ऑफ इन्फ्रेंस फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट डिस्क्रीट स्ट्रक्चर्स एंड थ्योरी ऑफ लॉजिक फॉर सेकेंड ईयर स्टूडेंट्स सीएससी एंड आईटी स्टूडेंट्स. मूविंग ऑन टू द टॉपिक, rules of inference provide the templates or guidelines for constructing the valid arguments from the statements that we already have. Those statements, we call those statements as premises, and the conclusion we derive from these premises. An argument is a sequence of statements. The last statement is known as conclusion, and the preceding statements are called premises. Let's say we have number of premises P1, P2, P3, and so on. Then, from all these premises, we can derive a conclusion which P1 and P2 and P3 and so on till the last premises gives the result conclusion. When all of these premises are true, it implies that the conclusion is also true. A valid statement is one where the conclusion follows from the given premises. First of all, there are a number of rules in theory of inference. First one is addition rule. If P is a premise, we can use addition rule to derive P or Q. What does it mean? It means if the value of P is true, here we can see if value of P is true, in that case, it doesn't matter if we perform OR operation with any of the variable, the result will only be true O. Value of P is true in both of the cases, then the result does not depend on the second variable. It results in the true itself. So we can derive from if one of the premises is true, then we can perform OR operation and the result is still true. Moving on to the let's see the example. Suppose one of the preposition here is he studies very hard. Let's say this is a P premise. We can derive either he studies very hard or he is a very bad student. Of course, one of these statement is true because this premise is already given. So we can derive this conclusion from this premise. Moving on to the second rule, which is if there are two premises P and Q, we can use the conjunction rule to derive the P and Q. It means we have two variables here, two premises here. If both of these premises are true, then only their result with AND operation is true. Let's see example here. He studies very hard. Let's say this is one of the premises P, and the second premises is he is best boy in the class. When both of these statements are true, then we can say he studies very hard and he is the best boy in the class. This conclusion is true because this statement is true. This is the AND operation and this statement is also true. When both of these statements are true, the result is itself a true only. Third one is simplification rule. If we are given P and Q is true, then we can say P is true. Let's see here. Here we can see this result here only gives one true value. Where both of these are true, then only it gives true result. So here we can say if the result is true, then we can say P is also true. P and Q gives P. We can write this whole of these premises and conclusion in this way, and we can verify this using truth table also. Let's see an example. He studies very hard and he is the best boy in the class. This is the premises that is given. We can conclude from this statement that he studies very hard. Of course, both of these statements are true, then only this whole of this P and Q is true. So we here P is also true, or we can say in place of P we can also derive here Q is also true. Next rule is modus ponens. If we are given a statement where P is one of the premises is true and another premises P implies Q is also true, then we can derive Q is also true. Let's see. As we can say, implication only gives false result in case of when the first premises is true and the second one is false. In only that case, the result is false. So here we can see this we are taking as true. So all these values are true. So these three cases we are taking, and then we are saying that P is also true. P is true in only these of two cases. Here we are having this particular case. From this we can conclude when P implies Q is true and P is true, then Q is also true. So we can, in this way, we can derive this conclusion. Let's see an example. If you have a password, then you can log on to the Facebook. First of all, if and then, this means it is a implication statement. If you have a password, this is, you have a password is P, you can log on to Facebook is Q. So we can write this statement as P implies Q. Next, you have a password. Of course, this statement is true. When these two statements are true, we can conclude you can log on to the Facebook. Q is also true. Next is modus tollens rule. In this rule, if we are given that P implies Q is true and not of Q is true, then not of P is also true. Let's say here P, Q. We can verify all of these rules using truth table. First of all, we are taking P implies Q is true. So these three cases we are taking. Here we are saying not Q is also true. We are saying not Q is also true. So this is the case where both of these values are true. Then we can say not of P. If we find not of P, which is, we can say when both of these results is true, then not of Q also results in true here. So in this way we can conclude that when P implies Q is true, not of Q is also true, then not of P is true. We can write this as P implies Q and not Q implies not of P. This is how we can verify this particular premises and conclusions. And when this is a tautology, then this whole expression is considered as valid argument. What does tautology means? It means that it results in true only. No false result will be there in the truth table in the last column where whole of this expression is written or calculated. Let's see an example. Here, if you have a password, then you can log on to the Facebook. Similar one, as we can write it as P implies Q. Second one is you cannot log on to Facebook. You cannot log on to Facebook means not of Q. Then this results in you do not have a password. That is not of P. Moving on to the next rule, which is disjunctive syllogism. In this rule, here we have not of P is true and P or Q is also true. In this case, we can derive Q is also true. Let's see. When we are saying not of P is true, that means we are considering these two cases, and P or Q is also true. That means these three cases are there. And if we can see, we are particularly talking about this case. When both of these expressions, not P and P or Q is true, then we can say Q is automatically true. Let's see example here. The ice cream is not vanilla flavored. Let's say ice cream is vanilla flavored. We are saying this is a premise P. Then ice cream is not vanilla flavored is considered as not of P. Then again we are having some P or Q premise. The ice cream is either vanilla flavored or chocolate flavored. So ice cream is vanilla flavored is P, and we are taking Q as ice cream is chocolate flavor. So this we are taking as Q. So in this statement we can write P or Q. This is P and this is Q. We can derive from both of these premises that ice cream is chocolate flavored. If ice cream is not vanilla flavored, of course it is the second one, the ice cream is chocolate flavored. This is what Q premises. We can derive this using disjunctive syllogism. Next one is hypothetical syllogism. When we are given P implies Q is true, Q implies R is also true, then we can have P implies R is also true. We can verify this using the truth table. Again, let's say because it is a three variable, so we are having eight cases here. Then we are having P implies Q, which is true, true, false, false, true, 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 true. Then again Q implies R, which is true, false, true, 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 false, true, true. So here we can see that these two and these are true values, and here the true cases are these. Okay. When both of these are true, we can say P implies R also true. Now we have to find P implies R. You can verify it by yourself using the implication that whenever these two are true, this automatically results in true itself. Let's see an example. If it rains, I shall not go to school. If it rains, let's say it is a P premises, and I shall not go to school is Q. We are taking it as Q. If I don't go to school, I won't need to do the homework. So again, this is what Q we have taken Q as I shall not go to school. Then I don't go to school is also the same. So it is Q. I won't need to do homework. Let's say this is a R. So if P implies Q, Q implies R, we can say if it rains, I won't need to do homework. So this is P and this is R. So P implies R is also true. Next one is constructive dilemma. Here we have, if P implies Q is true, R implies S is also true, and both of these results with AND operator is also true. In that case, if P or Q is true, P or R is true, then we can say in result Q or S is also true. You can verify it using the truth table just the same way that we did in the past slides using truth table. Let's say an example here. If it rains, I will take a leave. It rains. P, I will take a leave. Q. So this statement results in P implies Q. If it is hot outside, it is hot outside. Let's say this is R. I will go for a shower. This is S. Another. So because it is using if and if then it is. It represents R implies S. Either it will rain. This is true. And this is also true. Either it will rain. It will rain. P or it is hot outside. Hot outside we represented as using R. Then we can say I will take a leave, that means Q, or I will go for shower or S. We can derive these this particular conclusion. If all these three statements are true, then this will also result in true, Q or S. Next one is destructive dilemma. When P implies Q is true, R implies S is true, and the result among these true using the AND operator is also true, that means this whole expression, when the whole expression is true and the second expression not of this one and this one with OR operation is true, then we can say NOT of P and NOT of R along with OR operator is also true. You can verify it using the truth table. Let's see an example. Here we have, if it rains, I will take a shower. I will take a leave. So P implies Q. Second one is, if it is hot outside, I will go for a shower. It means R implies S. If this is R, this is S. R implies S. Then neither I will take a leave. Neither represents not. I will take a leave. Not of Q. Nor. Again. Not. I will go for shower. That means S. Or because there is OR operator. So we can represent this statement not of Q or not of S. Then we can conclude from these three statements that neither it rains, that means not of P, or it is hot outside, nor it is hot outside. So this is how we can jump to this conclusion using this simple rule, destructive dilemma. Now let's see an example where we are having number of premises. Let's say it is not sunny. It is not sunny. Let's say it is sunny is P, then it is not sunny is not of P. It is not sunny this afternoon. It is colder than yesterday. Let's say this is another premises. So we can write this statement as not of P and Q. Second, we are having, we will go swimming only if it is sunny. Only if, that means it is an implication. So it is sunny represents P, because it is not sunny represents not of Q. So this statement is P. We will go swimming. This is Q. Sorry, this is R. So we can say here R implies P. If we do not go swimming, if this is R, we will go swimming, then we do not go swimming is not of R. We will take a canoe trip. This is another premises, let's say S. Because here we are having if then, so not, this represents not of R implies S. Next one is, if we take a canoe trip, this is S, and we will be home by sunset. This is another premises. Let's say this is T. So here also we are having if then, so we can represent this particular as S implies T. Leads to the conclusion, we need to derive that this is also true when all of these four premises are true. So here let's see the solution. First one, we are given not of P and Q. This is true. Using simplification rule, we can say not of P is also true, because this is true, this is true, only then this particular premises is true. So we can say not of P is also true. We have used simplification rule here. Secondly, we are having R implies P, another premises. Here, when we use these two premises and apply the Modus-Tollens rule, we can reach that not of R is also true. Because this Modus-Tollens says, if this is true and this is true, then we can derive that this is also true. So here we have written that we have used Modus-Tollens, and on these two premises, it results in not of R. Again, we are having third premises as not of R implies S is true. So this is another premises. Using these two, number 4 and 5, we derive that S is true using Modus-Ponens rule. Modus-Ponens rule says, if P implies Q is true and Q is true, then we can say P is also true. This is the Modus-Ponens rule. So here we are having not of R implies S and not of R. So we can say S is true. Next one is another premises, that is S implies T. Using S implies T and S, we can say again Modus-Ponens, it results in T. This is the conclusion. At last, we reach to this conclusion, which is T. T is, we will be home by sunset. So this is how we can derive a conclusion from the given premises. Let's see another example. Here we are having, if I am sick, there will be no lecture today. Let's say this is premises P. Or according to the, let's say this is premises S, there will be no lecture today, not of L, for example. So we can write this particular as S implies not of L. Again, either there will be a lecture today, there will be a lecture today, that means L, all the students will be happy. Let's say this is another premises which we can represent using capital H. Then we can write this whole premises as L or H. Third one is the students are not happy. Then this is of course not of H, because we have taken all the students will be happy as H. Then the students are not happy can be considered as not of H. Leads to the conclusion that I am not sick. We need to derive that I am not sick, because we have taken S as I am sick. So this I am not sick represents not of S. Let's see, all these premises are given. These are given premises. From here, if we are taking these two premises and apply disjunctive syllogism on these two, then we can reach that L is true, because L or H, this is true, this is also true. In that particular case, this L will also be true using disjunctive syllogism rule. Again, when we applied these Modus-Tollen rule on these two premises, premises 1 and premises 4, where S implies not of L, and this is true, and L is also true, then we can say not of S is also true. We can reach that not of S is true. This is the conclusion itself. So we can say that all of these hypotheses are true, and we have proved it using the rules of inference. One more thing that I need to explain is that we can verify it using the truth table. How we can verify it? We are having three premises here, which are S implies L, L or H, and not of H. When all of these are true, then not of S will also result in true. You can verify it using the truth table, or another way to verify it is when this particular premises is true and L or H is also true and not of H is true, then this implies not of S. Whole of this expression must result in tautology. Tautology means all of the output results in true itself, then only we can say this particular expression is true. So these are the two ways where we can find that a particular argument that we are given is true or not. First of all, using the theory of inference rules, and secondly, we can verify it using this particular expression, where premises 1 and premises 2 and premises 3 implies the conclusion. So this is how we can verify that the particular arguments are valid or not. Thank you.